African dream is to empower, you know, young people, both men and women, to realize, you know, their full potential, to meet, you know, this psychological state of self-actualization, so that, you know, they become, you know, effective and competent, you know, leaders for tomorrow. University of Zimbabwe is a national institution or a public institution. It is the oldest institution, you know, in the country, which opened its doors to the young, you know, minds in 1955. Now, naturally, the University of Zimbabwe, as you know, a public institution, caters for, you know, all Zimbabweans. You have almost 95% of the students coming from really the poorest, you know, families. This is the extreme end, you know, of poverty that you are talking about. And so naturally, the parents have no gainful employment, and so someone has to intervene, you know, to give them. This would be a new environment, taking into account that some of them would have gone through high schools situated in rural areas where, you know, there are very minimum standards that are insisted upon. When they come here, they need to fit into a new environment. And this is a competitive environment. Socially, academically, intellectually, it's a very highly competitive, you know, environment. So students need, you know, books, for example. And these students from very, very poor families cannot afford, you know, that. Students need to pay tuition fees. Most of them find it practically impossible, you know, to pay. But students also need money to stay in university accommodation. That is almost just a dream. Here you are talking, you know, about individuals coming from families that have no gainful employment. And so being able to sustain the kinds of conditions required for serious academic work becomes a very serious challenge, you know, to most of these, you know, students. Some of them don't have even enough, you know, clothing, you know, to put on, which can act as a negative force in terms of trying to concentrate on your academic, you know, business. You know, you have to talk about basic needs like soap, you talk of stationery for them to use here. Those appear to be very simple and cheap, you know, things, but they can present almost an impossible challenge for most of, you know, these students. You can almost imagine a student who, and there are a number of them, who has, you know, to walk to the university every day of, you know, the week to attend, you know, lectures, to be able to do practicals in labs and so forth. And that is very draining. African dream, you know, as a concept, as an organization, fits into what we generally call other important stakeholders in the education of, you know, the youth. Look, some of the students coming from very, very poor families are generally some of the best. The African dream scholarship becomes a very, very important intervention in assisting. Even if you assist, you know, very few, you know, students, that is a significant contribution, because you must look at the impact this will have. You're supporting someone with very high, you know, intellectual capacity, someone who's very, you know, strong academically. You are actually empowering the nation. If we deny them access to university education, then you are shutting off, you know, the whole world, you know, to them. Assist, you know, one, assist two, you know, individuals who have the capacity to learn, who are highly motivated, but who are very, very poor because of the socioeconomic circumstances of their families. Then you have empowered not just the family of the individual and the individual, but you are actually producing leaders, you know, for tomorrow. You know, as people, it's not the color which matters. It's what we develop in our minds, which is important. And that is the kind of development and training and nurturing that we want to give these young people. Give everyone an opportunity to realize and fulfill their dreams.